Cameron, that wreck killed two and sent two children to the hospital. Now, all of those children involved in that wreck attended Jamestown Elementary. The students and teachers are dealing with a lot, but Guilford County Schools are providing counselors to help them deal with their loss, but mostly to answer questions.
At Jamestown Elementary, everything appears normal. But as students prepare for their EOG testing, they are forced to deal with the difficulties of life.
It has been very tough for our students and our teachers.
Three students are absent, and at least one of them will never return. Fifth grader Taylor Strange lost her life Sunday morning. The car she was riding in collided with a state trooper as he attempted to pull over a speeding car. That crash also sent two other Jamestown students to the hospital with head injuries. Taylor's cousin, Stephen, and their friend, Elijah Allman, continued their recovery at the hospital. The two are unaware of Taylor's passing. The same can't be said for the students at Jamestown. Many of them expressed their feelings in cards to Taylor's family.
Dear Strange family, Taylor was one of my friends. You should know that many people were crying today. Almost the whole fifth grade was crying.
The school's crisis team talked to many of the students and sent letters home to parents to make sure they further address any concerns.
We know that they will move through stages of grief, and we are recommending different publications. We're recommending them to talk with their children, and then if they start to see signs that it becomes more and more difficult for their child, like excessive crying, etc., having trouble sleeping at night, that they contact us at the school, and then we will connect them with other agencies in our communities.
Now, the driver of that car, Sandra Aldman, also died in that wreck. Now, the accident remains under investigation. At the same time, we do know that Highway Patrol will shut down Business 85 right where that accident happened starting tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. They're going to reconstruct the accident. Essentially, Cameron, we're hearing that they will basically try to figure out the speeds. That road will be shut down until 1 p.m., so they're asking people to avoid that area as they try to pinpoint exactly what happened Sunday afternoon.